Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Obelisk in Southampton for the Thursday Shield final. Just about to get underway here. First frame of the four for the Chandlers Four Club, we've got Don Lamont. And for the Ice House B, we've got Melvin Herridge. Small delay while everyone gets their phones onto the 4G, 3G network around here to watch it. Plenty of people hovering around me, so I'll speak to you here. Lots of names and faces and voices of people that you'll recognise, like Sambo stood next to me. Evening, Sambo.
Evening.
Seven at the moment. All right, Mikey Smith's refereeing this first one. And if you want to put your comments up on Facebook, then I'll try and answer them and mention you and all sorts of stuff. Hopefully Ian Tarrant, you're watching. Thank you very much for your payment for the registration of the summer season. Got a pretty impressive number now. Registered. We are up to, on a Tuesday we've got 32 teams, and on the Thursday we've got a maximum of 42, and so far 41 are registered.
Does your committee member know that a Wembley's got to be in the bottom left corner?
Don Lamont to break. Don Lamont to break, and he's pied.
Who trains these committee members, Pete?
And I will just take a moment to remind Sambo that his voice can be heard quite clearly over this microphone as well. Don's on reds and Melvin on yellows. Tuesday final, this last Tuesday between the chapel and the Elephant and Castle. It's available now on our YouTube channel. As will this after the match. Should hopefully be stored for prosperity on the YouTube channel. The only proviso on that is that YouTube doesn't try and sting me for some sort of copyright again. Good shot there by Don, just a little tickle on his red. Lovely shot there by Don. It was a tight call for a total, which it wasn't. It was a hell of a shot to get a little nudge on that red. Pressure's definitely on Melvin here. Melvin is playing his classic shots here, pulling them all out of the bag. If you didn't hear that, that was Gary Coward just saying he's up next against Dave Herridge, so he reckons he'll be a lot quicker. Like I say, I will need to mute the volume every so often, certainly when there's songs playing, like the one in the background at the moment. So unfortunately, you will appear. We'll get every so often get a little bit of silence. So with two shots here, using the one red to try, one shot to try and tie the red up a little bit. I think Melvin's confidence is probably quite high winning this first frame. Good little shot there by Melvin to bring the other ball into play. 99% of the time you'd expect him to clear up here. Melvin getting himself into a bit of a pickle there. I think he's managed to, from where I'm sat, it looks like he's possibly covered that red to the top bag. Good effort there by Don, but I think he's left it wide open for Melvin. Yeah. And there it is, 1-0 to them at Ice House. Back for frame two, China's four club got Dave Herridge and Ice House B, Gary Coward. Like I say, don't forget to get over to our Facebook page, send in your comments. Am I too loud? Am I too quiet? How's the stream? Is it streaming good? Is it stuttery? Stick a comment on there and let us know. So Dave Herridge to break. That's a good split. He's potted a yellow. I'm hoping one of the players tonight will actually break and dish, because I've got a little animation I'd like to play. It'd be a shame not to use it. Like a whirlwind around the table. Season pro is Gary Coward. Pro in the SRPL anyway. Played plenty of money matches. I think he might have even won one as well. I think he's got himself a little bit tied up there. That was unfortunate, just a couple of millimetres away from being on that red. He's let Dave back in. All the yellows pretty nicely positioned, to be honest. It's a bit unfortunate that. Left him a nice little tap in. Back on the black. Same game to ourselves. Next up for the China's Four Club, we've got Keith Palmer. And for the Ice House B is Paul Pullum. Keith wins the lag by a country mile there. No. For those of you that are able to watch us live at the moment, I'm being told that it is a little bit delayed and stuttery and stuff. I can only apologise for that. Unfortunately, there's no 4G down here, and we've had to opt for going onto the pub's own BT Infinity line, which won't have the same sort of upload speed. What I will endeavour to do is I'll check it all out tomorrow. This is all be saved anyway, and if it's too choppy and the recording on YouTube is too choppy, I'll take it down and replace it with the live copy that I'm making now. So it will disappear for a little while I do that, probably later on tomorrow evening. One option for you, though, those of you that are struggling with the stream, if it is stuttering a lot, you should have the functionality on the YouTube page to actually go back a minute or so, which obviously means you won't be live, but it shouldn't stutter as much. Good effort there by Dave. I'd love to be able to show you, but they've managed to get our live stream up on every single TV in the pub down here. So it's about 2 minutes behind, which is a bit of a shame, but it's good to see it all live around the pub. So he's got away with that one. Yellow's a little bit awkward, but he's unfortunately put the black a little bit safe as well. Good effort by Dave there, left the white nice and tight on the red. Great shot there by Paul. It's going to be interesting to see what he pulls out of his pocket for the next shot. Wow. Didn't expect that shot from Paul. He's pretty much handed the frame to Dave. Shot on a visit. Visit and a shot. Two shots, however you want to call it. There is the official way. Oh my word, oh my word, cannot believe. It's awful, awful luck for Dave there, for Keith. We'll be right back. Okay, we are back. Apologies if the stream cut out at all there. We were just trying to make it a little bit more guaranteed for the viewer. We're on to the fourth frame now. Chandlers 4 Club, Anthony Ireland, and Ice House B, Sambo Wildham. There we go. Sambo wins the fourth frame for the Ice Elves. Hunky hunk. Right then, we've got a good old crowd turning up here now, and moving into the fifth frame for the doubles, we've got Chandlers Four Club, Dave Herridge and Saki Chung versus Ice House B, Stu Berry and Aaron Pello.
Stewie, you want to do that for the lag, mate? I'd love
that. In front of the camera, come on. Sambo managed to find a little stall down there for Stewie. Hell of a break there by Stu. Nice spread. Don't forget we've got plenty more live streams coming up. To the Facebook page, our Facebook group, and click on events at the top. Next Monday the 20th, we've got the Black Ball singles final, live from Rocket Ronnie's. That's Kev Butler versus James Hoskins. That's starting about 8:30 on Monday. Following day, Tuesday the 21st, we have the Tuesday Team Cup knockout final. We're live from the Hinkler, and that's the Gardener's Arms versus the Bitten RBL. Following Thursday, the one that everyone's waiting for is the group draw for the summer season. Registration closes this Sunday, and we have one place left on a Thursday. So if you're a Thursday team and you're not in yet, you literally have until Sunday, if not before, depending on whether someone else gets in before you. But next Thursday, like I say, on the 23rd, about 7:30, 7:45, we'll be doing the live draw from the Pear Tree for the summer groups. And that will be followed straight away at 8:30 by the Thursday Team Cup knockout final between the Brass Monkey and the Ice House A. Two other events in the next week, 27th of March, the Monday, we've got the Blackboard Doubles final. That's again at Rocket Ronnie's. And that is Kevin Putt and Paul Wyeth versus Melvin Herridge and Ryan Longhurst. The very next day, Tuesday the 28th, is the Old Rules, God bless them, the Old Rules final. And that's Melvin again against Alex Cherkov, and that will be live from Rocket Ronnie's.
Fucking hell, Aaron!
Unbelievable. While I'm talking, Aaron has managed to pop, inadvertently pop the black. So, 4-1. Okay, we're back. Hell of a lot of food here, so hence the long break. Next up for the China's Four Club is Saki versus Aaron. With the ice out. Looks like that's going to be Aaron's lag. And Aaron's break. Dry break there from Aaron. A little bit unlucky there to nudge the black into a less possible position. Aaron seems to be playing like someone's possessed him. Saki's back on the table. Great cut there by Saki. Will he get the luck of the table and get an angle on that red? Wow, that was an unlucky double there. Aaron's got a bit of work here to get that red near the bottom cushion. A bit of yellow even. Cracking shot there. Not sure from here if he's got the angle on that or if he's got the space to get that yellow in the corner. There was the angle. And he's got himself plumb on that yellow just to get himself back up for that black to win the match for the Ice House. Four. Camera's in the best position for this one.
Yeah, good fitness,
no. That wasn't an easy shot, fair play. It's not left it easy for Saki. From where I'm sat, it looks different to where the camera is showing. Looks pretty straightforward. From where I'm sat, it's a little bit awkward. It's good. One good pot on the black to take him to two behind. Unlucky, he's left it right over the middle. Nice game, Ice House, 5-1. Congratulations, Ice. Sorry about the stream for everybody who was experienced all the stuttering. I will be uploading the recorded file from tonight tomorrow, and obviously the link will be on posted on Facebook as soon as that's done. We will see you next Monday.